Kdenlive is a community project which aims to deliver a free and open video editing software application to allow everybody to produce quality content in order to increase the democratization of the media. The application is a graphic interface written in C++ with Qt and KDE libraries for the MLT framework written by Dandenity, which relies on FFmpeg to decode and encode almost all the video and audio formats that are out today, and which hosts effects libraries like Freyr and MoveIt for video and LadSpot and Sox for audio. By following the official documents that we can find on the internet, the project was launched by Jason Wood, who released version 0.2.3 in October 2003. Soon, Kdenlive 0.2.4 followed, but the community did not yet exist and the group was very small. The project stopped for 2 years. Before the end of 2005, Jean-Baptiste Mardel, who heard that the project would be reactivated, offered his help, and in 2006, he signed the post of the new release 0.3 of the program. From this moment on, he became the main reference point for the project. Version 0.4 and 0.5 are soon distributed, but there is an issue. A refactoring of the code is needed to go forward. The program has to be moved from KDE 3, which is not compatible with MLT, to KDE 4. The rewriting ends in 2008, followed by several new releases, but in 2011, a further migration from KDE 4 to KDE 5 was needed to allow the program to grow. In 2012, a crowdfunding campaign is launched to fund the operation, and before the end of 2014, the goal is reached. Then finally, in 2015, Kdenlive becomes an official KDE application. Jean-Baptiste was invited to Academy to present 10 years of activity. The new perspective is to make the project even bigger. Before the end of the year, the first Kdenlive Cafe is announced with the aim of getting more people involved. During this virtual meeting, it immediately became clear that in order to grow, Kdenlive needed to be cross-platform. The Windows version was announced and 2016 began with a sprint meeting followed by the new logo and the new site. But as soon as the development of new features started, it was evident that the code for the timeline had to be rewritten because it was too old and no longer fit. Everybody knew that the refactoring could take several months or years, but the community did not lose enthusiasm. In 2018, a new roadmap was written, and in 2019, the refactored code was distributed, although some fine-tuning was still needed. To overcome this, the focus of the community in 2020 has revolved around fixing and improving the program. The result of this is the latest version, 20.08, which delivers stability, several new features, and a new interface with 5 workspaces.